For more on that race for Nevada, KCRA 3's political reporter Kevin Riggs is live in Las Vegas tonight for a look at what they're doing to prepare. Good evening, Kevin.
Good evening, Teo and Edie. We are live at the Cashman Center in Las Vegas, where the caucus results will be tallied here beginning tomorrow. Certainly, the Democrats are rolling the dice with this caucus. The candidates themselves take it very seriously because this is the first state in the West to express its presidential preferences. But the gamble is whether there will be significant turnout at the caucuses. This is a long weekend, Martin Luther King weekend, and there's a question how many hospitality workers will be given time off to take part in the caucuses. In the meantime, the candidates themselves were mixing it up here in Las Vegas. First of all, Hillary Clinton. She has, of course, been talking about her experience in Washington, D.C., and no different today. She started her day visiting a small business in Las Vegas, playing up her experience in Washington, her ability to get things done, and at the same time, she was criticizing Barack Obama for what she says is his lack of experience. As for Barack Obama himself, he was not standing still. He took jabs today at both Hillary Clinton and John Edwards at a rally here in the city of Las Vegas. In fact, he accused Clinton of piggybacking on his economic plan. Of course, Obama has gotten the endorsement of the Culinary Workers Union over Hillary Clinton, and that is a big win for him. As for John Edwards, who's been trailing in the polls, he was portraying himself today during an appearance here as the underdog at a rally. He has been disappointed because he had pushed very hard for labor endorsements, and the big labor endorsements instead went to Barack Obama. So, once again, this caucus will be taking place tomorrow. Harry Reid, the senator from Nevada, the Senate Majority Leader, was the one who engineered this early primary here in Nevada, and he says it's important because this is a state that is heavy with labor. It's a state that has about a 30% minority population. So, in other words, it's a state, he says, that looks very much like the nation. The Democrats believe that the candidate who wins here will be demonstrating a real position of strength as they head into the other campaigns. Teo, Edie, back to you.
Well, Kevin, let's speak for a moment about the Republicans. They will be voting in Nevada, but the candidates have mostly been in South Carolina. So talk to us about that strategy for the candidates.
Well, that's right. And you talk to Nevadans, and frankly, a lot of them are very unhappy that the Republicans have not spent a lot of time and resources here. But the Republicans really have made a choice to concentrate their campaign efforts in South Carolina. It is very much more a natural constituency for them in the South, whereas the Democrats have made a real push to stake a claim here in the West. They believe that if they do well in the West, that will position them much better for a strong fall campaign. So that's why you have not seen the Republicans here like you have seen the Democratic push.
Okay, but a big day for both parties tomorrow. Kevin, thanks for that report.